In this video, we're going to go over the domains of life. All living organisms are classified into one of three domains. These three domains are the bacteria, archaea, and eukaryota, all sharing one last universal common ancestor here. Archaea and eukaryota are thought to share a separate common ancestor from bacteria. The bacteria consist of small unicellular organisms. Bacteria, as well as members of the domain Archaea, are considered prokaryotes, as they lack a nucleus and other membrane-bound organelles, differentiating them from the eukaryota. The main differentiating feature of the bacteria, separating it from the other two domains, is that they have a cell wall made of peptidoglycan. The archaea consists of primarily extremophilic, single-celled organisms. Like bacteria, they lack a nucleus and other membrane-bound organelles, differentiating it from the eukaryota. The main feature of this group is that they often live in extreme environments. They are extremophilic. Extremophilic organisms are those which thrive in extreme environments. One type of extremophile are the thermophiles, which have optimal growth at extreme temperatures. Another example are the acidophiles, which thrive in highly acidic environments. Another feature that sets it apart from the other domains is the structure of their cell membranes. The cell membranes of bacteria and eukaryota consist of a phospholipid bilayer. The phospholipids in these two domains consist of a fatty acid chain, ester linkages, and D-glycerol moiety attached to a phosphate group. In archaea, on the other hand, the phospholipids can form a bilayer, but are also sometimes found to form a monolayer. The structure of the phospholipid is also different. They have isoprene chains instead of fatty acid chains. These isoprene chains have many side chains coming off from it, giving it a different structure to the fatty acid chains in bacteria and eukaryota. They are also ether-linked lipids instead of ester-linked, which is attached to an L-glycerol moiety instead of a D-glycerol moiety. The last domain is the eukaryota. The eukaryota consists of the eukaryotic organisms and include the protists, plants, fungi, and animals. The main characteristic that differentiates the eukaryota from members of the other two domains is that they all have a membrane-bound nucleus within their cells as well as other membrane-bound organelles. They may be single-celled or multicellular, but all cells, including the single cell of single-celled eukaryote, have a nucleus and other membrane-bound organelles. Thank you for watching. If you want to support this channel, please subscribe and check out more of my videos.